If you can watch now, the industry called gospel music today, you see that a lot of it is solely for the aggrandizement. It is for the awards. It is for the popularity. And we use gospel as the foundation, gospel music, but we're building all of this carnality on top of it. Who can get an award and who can get the television spot and who's going to be on the televised award show and the like. And that becomes the goal. You go to the award shows now and you platform all of the gospel artists and all the new gospel music. And then you go to the reception afterwards and it's drinking and secular music. They got an open bar. They play nothing but secular music at a gospel award show. So this has become the norm because we've let down the guard. The guardians have let down the standard. And now there's another standard raised where it's all according to what you think is right. And the Bible said there's a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end of those ways are the ways of death. So that's where we find ourselves. We're singing a great message, but we're not living a great life.
So the word to those who look up to you, respect you, who believe in you, that may not know the way, like you say, the generation of today, so that they can, if they're on that path, what would you say to them to abort that mission?
Oh, man, there's so much to say because there's so much to institute and there's so much to dismantle.
Yeah.
And this generation that's risen up that doesn't know God really in that sense. There's a lot to say. The first and foremost thing that I could tell anybody in the multiple generations that are underneath me is let Jesus Christ really be the Savior. Let him really be the one who sanctifies us. Let's learn what sanctification really is. Let's come out from among them and be separate from them and not touch the unclean thing. And he said, everybody says, you know, God is we're all God's children. We're all God's children. That's not what 2 Corinthians says. He says, only when you come out from among them and only when you're separate from them, he said, and then I will be a father to you. It's conditional. And then I will be a father to you. And then you will be my sons and daughters because you've come out from sin. You are living like me now in holiness. So we've got to get back to holiness, live like God, and stop making excuses for the carnality that we've held on to that we wanted.
What's up, y'all? Gerald here, creator of Gospel Chops and your host for this YouTube channel, back with another video. Did you hear what Donnie McClurkin said? Did you hear how he described the gospel music industry? If you follow this channel, I've said it many times. The gospel music industry is still the music industry. And yet, when I look at the comments, I see some of y'all don't want to believe it. You don't want to believe it coming from me. When I post up Robbie Starbuck, you say, oh, he's a white boy. Does that change the truth? Even though you're wrong in that assessment, the man said he's Cuban. Go back and check the video. But I ask of you at this point in this conversation, what color is the truth? Gospel music is just a small segment of the music industry, set aside for those of you who want to acknowledge God in your music, cater to a certain demographic, but on the business side of things, it's still a portion of the music business. Doesn't sell as much, doesn't make as much money, therefore it doesn't get as much attention, but is still part of the evil music business. Therefore, evil things happen in the gospel music industry. You don't want to believe me? You don't want to believe Robbie Starbuck? Do you believe Donnie McClurkin? Gospel music legend. We fall down, but we get up. He's admitted to falling down many times in his career and getting back up. And he's come to a point in his life where he spoke on some of the dirty deeds that go down in the gospel music industry, gospel music award shows, gospel music events, gospel concerts. If you don't want to believe me, believe Donnie. But the real question is, what is the fix when we sing Jesus and we declare Jesus, but we come together at gospel music events, such as the ones he spoke of, and they look just like secular events, drinking, smoking, partying, at gospel music events? A few weeks ago, I posted a video about Maverick City Music, and somebody sent me a private message and said, yo, we went to a Maverick City Music concert, and we were allowed to buy beers and have drinks and party all during the show. The bar was open. While they're on the stage declaring the power of God, the bar is open. Guess they bought the stage, but didn't buy the bar. So people are partying in the midst of Maverick City Music. According to Donnie McClurkin, people are partying at gospel award shows, at gospel events. This is the music business, something totally separate from the music itself. You can still make good music. You can still have a positive impact on the culture and not be a part of this segment of the gospel music industry. Will you make that choice? Will you be that one? Seems like Donnie McClurkin has seen these things going on for some time, but he's just come to the point in his career where he's ready to talk about it. How do you feel about the current state of the gospel music industry? Do you think things are okay? Or do you think things are going down, down, down? Let me know in the comments. I'd like to know what you think on this issue. Shout out to Donnie McClurkin for speaking truth to power. Let's see if we can turn this ship around. Let me know in the comments. What's the solution to a gospel music industry that's been infiltrated by carnality, that's been infiltrated by the thirst for money in an industry that don't make much money? And if the artists are starving, what do you think of the musicians who play for these artists? Be honest now. Let me know in the comments. Like the video. Subscribe to the channel. And share the video so we can get more musicians involved in the conversation. And like I always say, y'all, always remember and never forget. Without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time. Peace.